So we're going to do our lesson today. We have... Do what?
Oh,
sorry. We are going to start with our dictionary practice. If you remember, we talked about our alphabet and we broke it into... What do we call each one of these sections?
Quartiles.
Good. And how many quartiles are there in the dictionary? There are four. And who can remind me of the little song, poem, sentence we made up to help us remember the...
Never swear.
Good, and that gives us the first letter of each quartile so that then we can figure out which letters are in each quartile. So quartile 1 is A through
D.
Quartile 2 is
E through N.
Quartile 3 is
N.
And quartile 4 is
S through Z.
Very good. Good job. Okay, let's name and point the alphabet real quick before we get started. Ready? Can y'all point to it with me? Just put your finger underneath it. Let's go through it. Ready? A.
E, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, N, L, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y.
Awesome. Good job.
I just
good
have
good job. Okay, so we are going to start today with a word of the day. If you remember our word of the day page, right? We haven't done it since before the holidays, so we're going to get back on track to doing at least one of these a week. And so we're going to start today with a new word. And I sharpened some pencils for you. And here is your word of the day that you are going to put in the word of the day star. Are you ready? I'm going to write it on my paper right here.
Star?
Doesn't that look like a starburst or...
Oh, I thought
it
meant the star
test. Oh, no. Okay, here's our word. Do you notice something in this word that we've worked on before?
V.
We've talked about the V.
O-I.
O-I, good. What do we call O-I? O-I is a...
Oh, wait.
No.
Good. O-I is a diphthong. So I picked a word that used something that we've been practicing. So, do you know the word? Avoid. Avoid. Good. Write it in your starburst for today. We've also been practicing lately if we can find these words in the dictionary in less than a minute. Remember?
Oh,
I know. It's always tricky. But let's talk first about what quartile are you going to find avoid in. That should be pretty simple.
One.
Good. Quartile one. So put that on your page. Remember up here. Quartile one. And you're going to try to find now, as quickly as you can, the word on the page so that you can find the page number and the guide words, okay? So you may get started. I'm going to time you, but it's not, if you don't find it in a minute, that's okay. But you know it's in what quartile?
One.
Quartile one. Good. Use those guide words. Use your guide words. Here's your alphabet right here if you need it. These way down here. Okay, so look, here's AU and here's BA. Could it, here's U. So was it, oh, hey. Let me see your page, L. There you go. Y'all are all on the right page.
Found it.
Good. Okay. So write the
page. Wait, I didn't.
That's
found
okay.
It.
Okay. Write the page number down.
28.
Shh.
Sorry.
Don't close it because you're going to need it.
I never did.
Write the page number down and then find your guide words. What are your two guide words?
Author.
Author and
back.
Good. Author and back. Do you know what page to go to now? Because you wrote it down. So. And you all were fast. That was, it was right about at a minute. Now, I want you to look at the word avoid for just a minute in the dictionary. And tell me what you notice about the word avoid and its definitions.
It's a verb.
It is a verb. Great. What is a verb? A verb is an... Action word. A verb cannot be a noun. Remember, what is a noun? A person, place, or thing. That's your who or what of your sentence, right? The verb is your action word, okay? So you're going to label your definition, VB, with your verb. And then tell me, once you write that, tell me what else you notice about that definition. I see more than one. Do you see more than one definition for the word verb?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, for the word avoid?
Mm-hmm.
How many do you see there?
Three.
Which one do you think is the most common? One, two, or three?
One.
One is going to be the most common, okay? So we don't have to write down all three. I'm going to ask you to write down definition one and definition two, okay? So if you look, I wrote them down on mine so you could kind of see what it would look like. And here's the first definition. Who can read it for me?
To keep away from.
To keep away from. Good. And what's the second definition? Can someone else read it?
To keep from
happening. Good. To keep from happening. So, there are the definitions for the word avoid. Notice what else I did, though.
Oh my gosh, my hand hurts so bad.
Why?
I don't know.
Do you need a pencil grip? I think I put them all back in my little bucket. So if you look at this, what did I do? I numbered them because we want to know when it's a new definition. So put a number one and then put a number two, just like the dictionary does. Okay. There's always an arrow on these L if you look right here, and it shows pointing down, so that always tells you how it's going to go on your pencil. Okay? There you go. Okay, so we have our definition.
No.
Oh, it's right here, excuse me. I wrote it in here because I know it's hard to copy out of those little dictionaries. Put this sheet to the side, and we're going to come back later in our lesson to do the synonyms and antonyms and the sentence, okay? But while we're working today, I want you to think about that word avoid and think about a sentence as we're working today that you might be able to use for that particular word. So again, what quartile did we work in today?
One.
Quartile one. And what letters are in quartile one? A through
D.
D. Good. A through D. Very good. Okay. What'd you say?
I said A through D.
What? Where have you been?
Well, she's...
No, like, I got it mixed up because, like, the U...
Oh, I was just going to write on here today. Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay. So, we are going to get started today, and I am going to go through our decks first before we start our lesson. I almost did it out of order.
Always first.
I know. I don't know what I was thinking. Slide that one in there. Okay, we've split our decks, remember? So we are going to just do half today. Okay? Are you ready? Here we go. Name the letters.
Diphthong
O Y. Diphthong O I. What is this? Thank you. Good job. Okay. So we will start with these tomorrow.
Tomorrow.
Mm-hmm. Okay, let's do this half. You ready?
Coin,
oi. Okay, I'm going to go back to this one. Elephant what?
Elephant.
E. Good. Equal E.
E. Free. K. A. Boy. Boy. Socks. Nose. Candy. Fly. I. Umbrella. Unicorn. U.
Peyton, are you having a rough day today? Jam.
Fish. Goat. Good. Bird. Yarn. Kike. Valentine. Wagon.
Wagon what?
Wagon. Oh. Bat. Book. Book. Moon. Ooh. Light. Eye. Box. Zippers.
Good job. Very good. Okay, so we'll say those. Switch them and we'll know which ones we're going to do tomorrow. Okay, now we're ready for our new lesson. We're going to come back and do our spelling deck in just a little bit. Okay, so I'm going to write some words on my paper and I want you to watch as I write and I want you to tell me what you notice. Okay, tell me what you notice.
I noticed nothing right now.
Well, that's good then because I haven't written anything. It's a blank sheet of paper. Think for a minute.
And then over here.
Just think. Just think. I like how you're thinking. I like how you're looking at what I'm doing and your brain is thinking. Okay, so I want you to look at my two columns of words. Okay? And we are going to do some coding and reading of these words first, okay? So tell me what you see in this first word that we know.
OI.
What do we call it?
Diphthong.
Okay, and how do we code it?
With a diphthong.
With an...
Smile.
What do we call that? Smile and anything. Someone earlier in my group. Do you know what someone called it in my group earlier? I was just teaching them like their second combination. And she goes, it's a noodle, like a macaroni noodle. And I was like, it does look like a macaroni noodle, but it's called an arc. Remember? Arc. Okay. So what's the word?
Boil.
Good. Okay. I see diphthong OI. It needs an arc. What's
boil.
The word?
Boil.
Good. I see a C before an O, so I know it says K. I see diphthong OI. The word is
coin.
Who can code this one for me? You want to code it for me? What do you see?
OI.
Diphthong OI. What's the word?
Point.
Good. Who wants to do the next one? Kaylee, what do you see? Good. And then I see this C before an E, and I'm going to tell you it says we haven't talked about that yet. I put a word on there we haven't done yet. What's the word?
Voice.
But I knew Kaylee would know that word. Miss Disney actress that she wants to be and all. Right? May. Oh, you've changed your mind? All the before the holidays, that's all you could talk about. Being a Disney princess at Disney World. Okay. Okay. So, good job over there looking at these words. Tell me about this word. How are we going to code it? Kaylee, Peyton, you want to code that one? What do you see? Diphthong. What's the word?
Boy.
Good. Okay, let's go to the next one. I see diphthong O-Y. What's the word?
Play.
Oh, can't be play if I see diphthong O-Y. O-Y.
Boy.
Ploy. Good. I see diphthong O-Y.
Toy.
Now, what do you notice about these words down here? They're longer, aren't they? Let's look and see how many vowels we have. I see one, two. So how many syllables are we going to have?
Two,
right? So I'm going to divide it between the two consonants. I see diphthong O,
Y.
What's the word?
Employ.
I see two vowels. I'm going to code them. I see diphthong O, Y.
Destroy.
Good. Okay, so we've read the words. Let's go through and read them one more time now that they're coded. Boil.
Spoil. coin, point, voice, boy,
ploy,
toy,
employ, destroy. Good. Now, I want you to look at the words in this column and tell me what they have in common.
They all have O-I.
They all have diphthong.
O-I.
Okay. Tell me what's the same about these words.
They all have O-I.
They all have O-I. Okay, that's the basic thing you can tell me about the words. Now I want you to think a little bit deeper about them. Okay? What else do you notice about the words in this column versus the words in this column? Use some of those words that we've talked about when we're thinking about, when we look at words and we really delve into them and think about them. What do you notice about, what do you notice about them?
They make different sounds. Wait, no, they don't.
Nope, they both say oi, don't they?
Mm-hmm. They all have different letters.
Well, yes, they do. You're right, because they're different words. Think deep.
One
what?
Syllable.
Okay, great, Peyton. This column over here only has one syllable. There are two words over here that have two syllables. That's thinking deeper. Now keep going. What else do you notice? What about the location
and
of the oi sound?
At the end. And in the middle.
Yeah. Oh, what's in the middle?
O-I.
Diphthong O-I is in the middle. And diphthong O-Y is at the end or in the final position. Oh, is that thinking deeper about the words?
Mm-hmm.
Does it tell you something then? Does it kind of give you an idea about the rule? Ella, need your head up off the table. Okay, I want to put one more word over here. And it's this one.
Oil.
Good, that word is oil. So in what position do you see O-I? That first position
beginning.
Is a dance move,
beginning
ballet move. We're going to talk about what do we know about words. What position do we see the O-I in these words?
Beginning.
What do we call that position? We said this is final. What do we call these two over here?
Medial
and what's the first? If I pick the first letters of your first and last name, those are your initials.
Oh.
Oh, Christmas break has us all forgetting everything. Okay, so O-I falls in what position? Initial or
medial?
And O-Y is going
final.
To come in what position?
Final.
So I'm going to put my two lines down there to show that all of the O-Y will come in the final position. Will we learn that there are some exceptions to the rule? Always, right? Okay. But now we can add this to our spelling deck. So when I say oi in the spelling deck, how are we going to respond? Diphthong O-I, final diphthong
O-Y.
Good. So this is what it would look like when you write it for the spelling deck. Diphthong O-I, final diphthong O, final position, sorry. Final position, diphthong O-Y. Any O things?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, we've learned lots of O's, but this makes a new sound. This doesn't
no,
say O's.
No, like anything like comma.
No, this is all we'll do for oi. These are the only two things that can make the oi sound. Diphthong O-I, final position, diphthong O-Y. Got it? Any questions about that?
No.
Are you sure?
Mm-hmm.
Tell me which position are we most often going to find diphthong O-Y, Peyton?
Final.
And tell me what position, Kaylee, will we find diphthong O-I? And the look up here.
Initial
and
medial.
Good. Why? One more question before we move on. Why can't OI be in the final position?
Because it won't make sense.
Why? What's the rule? What do we know about that letter I in the final position? Great, Kaylee. Go give yourself a shout out for your pocket. English base words cannot end in
I. I thought it can end in V.
Oh. Well, it can't end in V either. It's got to end in VE. We did talk about that. But it can't end in I either. Okay? We've talked about that. English base words do not end in I. So that's why we have final OY. Good job. Very good.
I think it ends in
Y. Okay. Okay. going to do a little bit of fluency practice today, and we're going to do some reading. And the reading that we're going to do today is going to be practicing that oi sound. So if you look at this page right here, the title is Mr. Moy's Toys. Do you hear the oi sound in some of those mm-hmm. words? I do. Do you? Mm-hmm. And you are going to go through, before you get started, and you are going to, oh, I forgot to bring highlighters. Peyton, could you get three highlighters? And before we get started, I want you to go through this passage, just scan through it, and I want you to highlight any words that have that oi sound. Can I have one too? I'm sorry. Any passage that has that, or any word that has that oi sound. How do we make that oi sound? Diphthong I or diphthong O Y. So do you see what I'm doing? I'm just going through, and if it's got a diphthong O Y or O I am highlighting it. Why do you think I want you to highlight it?
So you can read it.
Yeah, so when you're going to automatically think about it if it's highlighted then, that it's got to make that oi sound, right? There are quite a few, aren't there? I'm afraid I missed a couple. Good job finding them. I see lots of highlighting going on. What do you notice in this particular passage? Are there more diphthong OI or more diphthong OY?
OI.
OIs, yeah. OYs. Once you've highlighted, it's okay. If you accidentally skipped over one, that's okay. It's not going to make or break you, okay? But we're doing this to help us with our fluency as well, because those are words then you don't have to think about. When you see that OY, you know it says what sound?
Oi.
Okay? So what you're going to do now is you're going to give me your highlighter so you're not tempted to write while you're practicing. And I'm going to have you practice this story by whisper reading, where I can hear you, but you're practicing. And your goal, you're going to get to read it again. And your goal while you're reading today is to work on your fluency. Who remembers what I said fluency is?
Not sounding like a robot.
Not sounding like a robot. We want you to sound like you're talking to your friend. Remember on the playground I said, you're not going to go up to your friend and go, hey, Peyton, do you want to play soccer with me? You're not gonna, but your friend would look at you and go, what are you doing? Is something wrong with you? Are you okay? Okay? Right? So you're not gonna talk like that, so we don't want you to read like that. And how do you get better at reading?
Practicing.
Okay? So practice while you're reading today, reading this like you would read it to your friend. Okay? So go ahead and get started, and I want to hear you whispering because I'm gonna be listening to each of you. Okay, good job. You can stop where you are. Good job. Did it help when we had the words highlighted?
Yeah.
So you automatically knew those patterns because you know them. You know OY says oi, and you know OI says oi. So that's what we want our eyes to start doing is when we see those patterns, we automatically know those words and they come out very smoothly. Good job. We're going to use this paper again, not today, but we are going to use it again this week because we're still going to be working on that oi sound. So I'm going to take those back. And I want to ask you one more time, why is it important that we're fluent when we read? Why is that important?
So we don't sound like a robot.
So we don't sound like a robot. But what else is it going to help? Does it help you to understand a story if you read it more smoothly?
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Because it doesn't break up your thought process while you're reading. So it's important to become fluent. And the only way to become more fluent is to
practice.
Is to read. Right? Is to read and is to practice. Good job. Okay. So we're going to do a little bit of coding today. Y'all are really good with that oi sound. So we're going to code some words today with that oi sound being spelled with diphthong oi and diphthong oi. But the words are a little bit longer. And you have some more things that you're going to have to code. So before we get started, we are going to go over our little vowel theme song that you know. And we'll write it on the paper over here. Okay? We know that a vowel and a closed syllable is short. Code with a?
Breathe.
We know the vowel and an open accented syllable is long. Code with a?
Macron.
Good. We know that in a vowel consonant E, the E is? I startled you. Kaylee just almost jumped out of her chair with that bell. The same 9:30 bell we hear every day. Vowel consonant E. The E is
short.
Long. What? Hold on. Stop and think for a minute. Oh my goodness, the bell really threw us off. Vowel consonant E. The E is. Do we hear the E? Thank you. The E is silent and the vowel is.
Long.
So it gets a?
Breathe.
Oh, it's long. It gets
macron.
A macron. Okay.
Oh, yeah, because a line can never stop.
Wait.
Right.
Can we write more words in our booklet thing?
We will. We're not going to do that today, but we will. Mm-hmm. Okay. We also know that what do we do to something that has been added to the end of a base word? What do we do to a suffix that we put at the end of a base word?
We box it.
So we may have some suffixes that we need to box today. Okay.
You can already see.
You can already see some that we do? Okay. Mm-hmm. And what do we have to do if the word has more than one syllable? If we know that it has more than one syllable, what do we have to do to that word?
Bracket.
Not bracket. That's for final stable syllable. But remember, we look at the vowels and the consonants. And then what do we do?
Break it in half.
We break it in half. There you go. Okay. So what I want you to do is I want you to take a minute, and I'm going to have you code these words. I'm going to be watching, okay? But I want you to think about these things that you know as you're coding and reading these words. Okay? Go ahead.
Oh,
we didn't put that over here. We didn't put diphthong over here.
Oh, that's a lot.
Right? We don't have to write it. We're just going to put an arc. Because that's what we're working on today. remember if I can box it, that means I can take it off and still have a base word. Right?
Is this a two syllable? Can you box this?
Say the word. So how many syllables?
Coil
ing.
Two.
Two. But you've already separated it. How did you separate it? Because the suffix is by itself. Yeah, it's a suffix. But you don't need to split it here then. Because that L can't stand by itself. Mm-hmm. What's the word?
Coil.
Okay.
Is this the word?
I don't know. Is it coded? Can you take the S off and still have a word?
Yeah.
So what do you do to that S?
Boxing.
Good. And the word is?
Floyd.
Put the end on it. Now those are two syllable words, so what are we going to do? would you divide that? You're actually going to divide it after that first E.
But you can't divide it. Is this for the days?
Yeah. That just leaves that first syllable open. So the E is going to say what?
Right here?
No, you can't. No, listen. Look.
Is this for days?
Mm-hmm. So you're going to divide it here. And that's going to be open. Because you can't split up the diphthong. Don't ever divide between a diphthong or a digraph, okay? Okay, so will you read your words to me? Good. Read the words to me. Excellent. Good job. Okay, I'll take those. And we are going to go back to our word of the day. What was our word of the day? Do you remember? Anyone remember?
Avoid.
Good. Okay, so we have some more work that we need to do to our page. And we need to talk about the definition for a minute. Okay? Remind me, what is the definition of avoid? Give me definition number one. Kaylee? Good. L, give me definition number two.
To keep from.
Good. Okay. So I want you to think for a minute. Were you thinking about that word avoid at all? Can you tell me something that you avoid?
You forgot to put avoid on there.
Oh, we could have used that for one of our words. You're right. We could have. But we have it here, so we're good. Can you tell me something that you avoid in life? What is something that you avoid? Something that you stay away from. Oh, okay. You avoid fights?
Avoid spiders.
Avoid snakes and spiders. I avoid getting in trouble. Yeah. Right? You don't want to get in trouble, so you avoid it. You try to stay away from it. What else do you avoid?
Bullies.
I avoid asparagus.
Ew, I love asparagus.
You do?
Me too.
I do not like it, so I avoid it because I do not like it. That is just one thing.
Asparagus that long.
You like that?
Green.
So I avoid asparagus, but you do not, and that's great. I love that you love that vegetable. But Ms. Harkins doesn't, so I don't need it. Okay? So avoid means that you try to stay away from something. So let's talk about synonyms and antonyms for just a minute. What would be another word that means avoid? If you stay away from something, what's another word that you could use that means you stay away from it? I want you to think about a game you play in PE, where people are throwing balls at you, and you try to avoid them. So what word? You try to dodge the ball. That's another word for. That's another word for avoid. You try to avoid the ball hitting you, don't you? You dodge it. Good. So that's a synonym. You dodge something. Up here, synonyms.
How do you spell dodge?
D-O-D-G-E. Dodge. We haven't learned that rule yet.
D-O-D-G-E.
Here, I have it right here. Dodge.
D-O-D-G-E.
Good. So instead of saying, you could call it avoid ball instead of dodge ball.
Avoid ball.
Hopefully we play that game.
Okay. Okay, another word is this word right here. Who can read that?
Evade.
Good. If you evade something, you try to avoid it. You try to stay away from it. Evade. That's a good vocabulary word. Okay? Evade. Okay. Another one that you could use. Oh, this is a good one. If I am walking down the hallway and I try to avoid someone, I may bypass them and go down the side hallway.
By you.
That is an irregular word that we have worked on, but that has nothing to do with this. Remember, that's a swamp where alligators live.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Random. Okay, so if I'm walking down the hallway and I see Peyton coming,
I'll push her out of the way.
And I want to avoid her, I really don't, but if I did, I might bypass you and go by
Miss L.
Computer, what am I, Miss?
Bradford?
Bradley's room and go down the other hallway so I don't have to see you. Okay? So another word for avoid or dodge is bypass. If you bypass someone, it means you're avoiding by you, bypass, here it was. Yeah. Okay? So bypass means that you're trying to avoid someone. I would never bypass you because you always give me a hug when I see you in the hallway. Okay?
Always.
Okay. Give me now some antonyms for avoid. What would be the opposite? If you're not trying to avoid someone, you're trying to go towards them, right? So you're trying to meet them. You're not avoiding your meeting, right? Or you're trying to face them. Now, does that mean this face?
Yes.
No. It doesn't mean this face, but I'm trying to face you, meaning I'm trying to see you, not trying to stay away from you.
Is that anymore?
No. Okay. So, now I want you to think of a sentence. I'm going to share my sentence with you, and then I'm going to let you write your own sentence, okay? Here's my sentence. I turned quickly to avoid the pothole in the road. What's a pothole?
A big hole.
So I turned to, they do, in Willow Park, they fill them a lot, don't they? With that black stuff, yeah. So I turned to try to avoid the pothole in the road. I want you to think of something that you have tried to avoid. It might have something to do with your horse. It might have something to do with ice skating yesterday. Did you go? Okay, you went, so that was fun, but you may have tried to avoid doing something, like landing on your bottom side.
Okay. Well,
so, my mom went on a lot. Oh, no. Okay. So, when you're writing your sentence, though, what do we need to remember? What does the sentence have to have?
Avoid.
It has to have the word avoid, but it needs a capital letter and it needs a period at the end. I need to know who your sentence is about and what's your action word. What's your verb in your sentence? I'm giving you the verb. Avoid. Good. Okay, but I want you to look at the spelling of those words for just a minute because I know that you know how to spell this.
I tried to avoid myself.
Okay, but I see two words that we've practiced that you know. How do we spell try and how do we spell sister?
Okay.
Try. What makes the final I sound? Oh, excuse me. Hold on. Hold on. I want you to stop and think. How do we spell try? Tap it out, please. T-R-I. What makes the final I sound? What? That says A.
Oh. Oh, wait. I.
Have we ever talked about any words that have I, Y? How do we spell final I? Like in the word, listen to it, help her out. How do we spell final I, like in the word try? T-R-Y. Try. Okay. I try to avoid my sister, okay? What's your sentence?
I avoid talking to Isabella.
Okay. What's your sentence?
When I was ice skating, I tried to
avoid my sister. Okay, good. Now remember what goes at the end of that sentence. Good job. Okay, very good. Now you can take a couple seconds to illustrate. Actually, I'm looking at the clock. We're going to have to illustrate later, okay? Because I need to keep us on track and keep moving. Good job working on those sentences. So I want to ask you, what is important when you're writing a sentence? What do those sentences have to have?
Capital letter, a beginning.
Capital letter, a period.
And then.
It has to have who your sentence is about and
what.
Why.
What.
What.
Okay? Okay, we're going to do our spelling deck real quickly. We're not doing all of it today. We're just doing some of it.
Wait, you said we would do the page where we only did the page.
We're doing it on here.
We're
going to do it on here. You're fine now.
Oh, okay. Yeah, the other page we did, we have to.
Right. That's what we're going to do on here. We're only doing the ones today with the multiple responses.
Okay.
But we're doing them on here. This is just the paper we're using. Okay? So the first one is oi. Oi. Diphthong. O-I. Final diphthong. O-Y. O-Y. Good. D.
D.
Good.
E.
Comma. Suffix.
Comma.
Diphthong. Oh, I'm sorry. E. Digraph. E. E. Comma.
Comma.
E. Consonant. E. Comma. E. Final position. Digraph. Comma.
E. What?
Comma. Y. Okay. U.
U.
U, consonant E, comma.
Comma.
Yep. O.
O, consonant E,
comma. Okay, the next one. Jensen, I'm doing a little video real quick. You can just sit right there and hang out for just a second, okay? I'm not quite finished yet.
Okay.
Okay? You can just hang out, have a seat. You can get a book right there.
Okay.
Come back and do it when you come to class. Comma K.
Okay.
You tell me K, comma C. Final position, digraph CK, K. Comma.
Mm-hmm.
Right here. Okay. K E. Comma what?
Okay. C.
Mm-hmm. Z. Y'all are going to have to just chill for a second. I'm trying to do a video real quick, so what do you have to do later?
I have to go to the office and sign something.
Well, that's not going to take my whole class period, though. So go do that, and then I'll see you in my class. Bye. Z, comma, S. Ung. Comma. V, final position. Just one book and have a seat.
V-E.
You can look at that one. Good. I.
I.
Final position. Good. Okay. Good job. Comma. What?
Comma.
Not yet. What?
No.
Iris I.
I.
Mm-hmm. You know this.
I'm lost today.
Why?
Y'all are going too fast.
Okay, I'm sorry. Final position. What?
Y.
There you go. I'm sorry. Yes, I'm trying to speed it up and I shouldn't. I apologize. Okay, I want you real quickly to flip that paper over on the back. And I want you to draw a line down the middle. Turn it sideways like this and draw a line down the middle. Actually, draw two lines, meaning final position down the middle. In the first column, I want you to put diphthong OI. You don't have to write diphthong, just OI. Just write it. And then in the second column, I want you to write diphthong OY. Just write O Y, honey.
Every time you don't I do my Y's, I like shake and then I.
Okay, here we go. We're going to do a little spelling practice, and I'm going to give you a word, and you're going to decide which column that word's going to go in, and you're going to write the word, okay? Now, look at your chart for a minute. If you hear the oi sound in the initial or medial, how are you going to spell it?
O-I.
If you hear the oi sound in the final position, how are you going to spell it?
O-I.
How are you going to know? Well, I'm going to say the word. What are you going to do? Repeat the word. You need to say the word every time. You're going to repeat the word, and then you're going to do what?
Tap it.
Tap it out. And you can feel where that sound is, can't you? Okay? Okay. That's okay if you're watching. First word. Are you ready? The first word is toy. Repeat it.
Toy.
Tap it out. Okay? Now spell it as you go. Where did you tap and feel where that oi sound was? Do it with me. Oi. What position is that oi sound in? Oh, so where's it going to go in your chart? Oh, okay. So, good job. There you go. You see what I mean? It's going to either go here or here. Next word. I want you to do the word boil. Repeat the word. Boil. Tap it out.
Now I know.
We're going to just do two more words.
Okay.
I want you to do the word. Here, see? Ready? Spoil.
Spoil. Spoil. And boy.
I want you to do the word. Soy. Repeat it. Soy. Can you get it every time if you tap it out?
Yes.
Every time.
Maybe.
Do those procedures.
If you tap it out right.
That's great. Okay, and the last one?
I said you were going to do two more.
Did I already do two more?
Yeah.
Oh, I'm sorry. Okay. Okay, so question then. Here's my question. If I asked you to spell the oi sound in the word rejoice, how would you spell it? Tap it out. R-E-J-O-I-C-E. Where would it go? Is it initial, medial, or is it final? Rejoice. Look at your chart. Is it in the final? Is it the last sound you hear in the word rejoice? It would go over here. I'm not asking you to spell it. I'm just asking you to listen to it. It would go over here. I'm going to give you another one, though, just to check. Okay? What if I gave you the word destroy? Where would it go? How are you going to spell it? The oi sound. With O?
O-Y.
Good. Okay. Very good. Okay. We're going to keep working on this one. Y'all got it, but I think you're overthinking it a little too much. We are going to do a little listening comprehension real quickly. And I am going to read a short passage to you. And while I'm reading to you, I want you to be listening for that oi sound. And when you hear a word that has that oi sound, I want you to give me a thumbs up. Okay? Easy
Don't
enough?
Read fast.
I'm not going to read fast. Okay? So listen for that oi sound. Joy is playing with her friends outside. Her brother Troy wants to join them. Can I play with you? He whines. Don't be so annoying, says Joy. You don't need to whine. We agree that you can join us. We are playing tag. Troy jumps down. I like tag. Can I be it? He asks Joy. Jake says, I want to be it too. Joy spots a coin. We can flip a coin to see who will be it, she says. Joy flips the coin and Troy wins. Joy, Jake, and Troy play tag. Roy sees them playing and wants to join them. Can I play too? Asks Roy. Yes, you can. Join us, says Joy. Watch me and not her. Joy, Jake, Troy, and Roy play tag late into the day. Did you hear oi sounds?
Yeah.
When you really start to listen for them, you hear how many words actually have that. Good job. You all did a great job today. I appreciate it. Peyton, will you go push the button and turn me off?